वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा, वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह। यू आर वाचिंग सिख टीवी। आई एम सरबजीत कौर। लेट्स बिगिन द बुलेटिन विद द टॉप हेडलाइंस। क्रैकडाउन ऑन इलीगल माइनिंग इंक्रीज सैंड प्राइसेस इन पंजाब। फॉलोइंग अ फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस, पंजाबी यूनिवर्सिटी डिसाइडेड टू पे हाफ सैलरी टू इट्स एम्प्लॉइज। कमीशन ऑफ इंक्वायरी ऑर्डर्ड एक्शन अगेंस्ट पुलिस ऑफिशियल्स अंडर सेक्शन 182 इन जस्सी मर्डर केस। After getting a written assurance about their demands, Maharashtra farmers still called off. India stood on top with 9 medals in shooting World Cup. Leader of opposition Sukhpal Singh Khaira accused Charanjit Singh Channi for investing money in illegal sand mining through his nephew. Shromni Akali Dal will give memorandum to Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh on March 14 regarding farmers' debt waiver. A Bangladesh passenger aircraft crashed in Kathmandu killed at least 50 passengers. Now let's start with the detailed news. Sand prices have shot up across Punjab due to a squeeze in supply caused by the recent crackdown on illegal mining after Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh tweeted photographs of illegal sand mining in Namashar district last week. The sand prices have either doubled or sand for construction is not available as legal mining too has come to a halt due to strict implementation of restrictions on use of machines in mining. Till a week back, a trailer load containing 200 square feet of fine sand was supplied for ₹2,500. After mining in local quarries has stopped, the sand prices have either doubled or sand for construction is not available as legal mining too has come to a halt due to strict implementation of restrictions on use of machines in mining. Till a week back, a trailer load containing 200 square feet of fine sand was supplied for ₹2,500. After mining in local quarries has stopped, the sand rates have gone up to ₹4,500 and even ₹5,000 per trailer. A tipper containing 1,000 square feet sand was being supplied for ₹15,000 and now it is available for ₹25,000. Following a financial crisis, the Punjabi University authorities have decided to give only half pay to its employees for February. The university will also be making tax deduction from the half salary, which means that the employees will be left with hardly any amount to meet their monthly expenses. This is for the first time in the history of the university that the employees will be paid their salary in parts, and that too when the university gets its monthly share of government grant, that is about ₹7.34 crore. The total bill of salaries of its employees and pension of the retired staff comes out to be about ₹27.05 crore. Of this, the university has disbursed the salary and pension to its Class C employees, which come out to be only about ₹3.05 crore. However, the university is yet to pay ₹24 crore to its employees, but they don't have enough money for the same. Hounded by the police for several years following the brutal murder of his Canada-born wife Jaswinder Kaur Jassi by contract killers in June 2000, Sukhvinder Singh Mithu has finally got justice. The Commission of Inquiry into False Cases set up by Captain Amrinder Singh government has ordered action under Section 182 of the CRPC against the police officials concerned. It has also ordered that they pay compensation to be decided by the government for harassing him. Jassi was killed by contract killers allegedly hired by her mother Malkiyat Kaur and uncle Surjit Singh Badesha on June 8, 2000. Maharashtra farmers in Mumbai to Girao the state assembly to press for their demands called off their protest yesterday after a written assurance by Maharashtra government that their grievances would be addressed. Marching under the banner of All India Kisan Sabha for 6 days, the farmers descended on the country's financial capital in the wee hours yesterday. Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis set up a 6-member committee that began talks with a 12-member delegation of farmers. They later put forth 13 demands. After deliberations which lasted 2 hours, the CM announced that the farmers had called off their protest as the government had accepted all their demands. Their main demand was the transfer of forest land to tribals. A podium eluded them on the final day, but India had done enough to finish their best ever campaign at the ISSF World Cup in Mexico at the top of the medals tally with 4 gold, 1 silver and 4 bronze. 2-time Olympics champion Vincent Hancock of USA won the men's ski competition, the concluding event of the year's first International Shooting Sport Federation World Cup. Among the 3 Indian shooters in the fray, Samit Singh shot 116 in qualifying to be placed 15th, Angad Bajwa shot 115 to end in the 18th spot, while Shiraz Sheikh secured the 30th spot with a score of 112. Well, this is all what we have in this edition. Stay tuned for more updates, and again, let's have a look on news headlines. Crackdown on illegal mining increased sand prices in Punjab. Following a financial crisis, Punjabi University decided to pay half salary to its employees. Commission of Inquiry ordered action against police officials under Section 182 in Jassi murder case. After getting a written assurance about their demands, Maharashtra farmers still called off. India stood on top with 9 medals in shooting World Cup. Leader of opposition Sukhpal Singh Khera accused Charanjit Singh Channi for investing money in illegal sand mining through his nephew. Shromni Akali Dal will give memorandum to Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh on March 14 regarding farmers' debt waiver. A Bangladesh passenger aircraft crashed in Kathmandu, killed at least 50 passengers.